Okay. So in this chapter, chapter number 8, the bear story we are going to start. In this chapter, it is the story of a bear, where you know Bhalu. The lady in the manor house had a bear as a pet. And it was a most friendly bear who loved vegetables, apples and honey. He roamed freely during the day but was put on chain at night. So class, you see that in this chapter there is a story of a bear who was as a pet for a lady. And she was living in the manor house and she had a bear. And the bear was roaming freely during the day. It means nobody was keeping a push and keeping an eye on the bear at the day. But at the night, the bear was kept in the room and he was chained at night so that others can sleep freely without any hesitation. So they were a little bit insecure about the activities of the bear. थोड़ा बहुत वो लोग क्या थे इस बात से लेके चिंतित थे कि कहीं ऐसा ना हो कि बैर के इधर उधर घूमने से लोगों को कोई दिक्कत होने लगे. ठीक है, तो इसलिए वो लोग इस बात से डरते थे. चलो आगे है. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द टेक्स्ट. सो इफ एनीवन वांट टू रीड द स्टोरी काइंडली रीड. यस बेटा रीड. Anyone of you? Utkarshi, kindly read, beta.
Okay, ma'am. There was once a lady who lived in an old house on the border of a big forest. This lady had a bear that was very fond of. It had been found in the forest, half dead of hunger, so small and helpless that it had to be brought from the big water by the lady. And the old goat was 7 years ago, and now it had grown up a big bear. And strong. He could have a cow and tie it in a way and keep him if he wanted to.
But he did. Read, keep reading there.
But he did not want to. He was a most amiable bear. He did not treat harming anybody, man or beast. He used outside his kennel and look with his intelligent eyes most accurately at the cattle in the field nearby. The three shaggy ponies, his stable, knew him well and did not mind him pleased when she came into the stable with him.
Okay, stop. Listen, class. So in this story, we see that in the first paragraph that there was a lady and who lived in a manor house or the border of the big forest. So she was living beside the forest and one day she got a bear half dead with the hunger. It means who was starving. The small bear was starving and he was likely to be dead and at any time. And she felt pity for the bear and she carried the bear at her home and she kept her as her pet because she loved the small bear and the bear was so helpless at that time. So she was very kind lady, and that's why she kept the bear as her pet. And when it grown up, the bear grown up and it became a big bear, so big and so strong that it could have slain a cow. मतलब वो इतना बड़ा हो चुका था कि वो एक काव को मारने के लिए पर्याप्त था. And carried it away between his two paws. मतलब वो अपने दो पंजों के बीच में गाय को पकड़ कर ले जा सकता था. मतलब it was so strong. It has been compared by like this way. Okay, but he did not wanted to. But the bear was also very kind. He didn't want to harm anyone anyway. One day what happened, let's see. He didn't want to harm anybody. Man or beast. Beast मतलब क्या होता है? जंगली जानवर. Beast मतलब क्या होता है? जंगली जानवर. And he used to sit outside his kennel. वो क्या करता था? वो अपने kennel के बाहर बैठ जाता था. Kennel मतलब जो dogs का घर होता है ना, ऐसे ही bear के लिए भी एक घर बनाया गया था. And look with his small intelligent eyes most amicably at the cattle grazing in the field. बड़े ही प्यारी नजरों से वो किसकी ओर देखता रहता था? कैटल्स की ओर देखता रहता था. किसकी ओर? कैटल्स मतलब जो वहाँ पर जो दुधारू जानवर होते थे, लाइक गोट्स, लाइक काउस, इनको वो घूर कर देखता रहता था. एंड ग्रेजिंग इन द फील्ड मतलब कि उन्हें वो फील्ड में ग्रेस करते हुए देखता था नियर बाय. एंड द थ्री शैगी माउंटेन पोनीज. माउंटेन पोनीज के अंदर पोनी का मतलब होता है बच्चों एक तरीके से गधी. पोनी मतलब एक तरीके से गधी होती है, लेकिन वो जो होती है वो एक तरीके से खच्चर, जो फीमेल खच्चर होती है ना, समझ लो वही होती है. ठीक है, तो वो माउंटेन पोनीज को देखता था. इन द स्टेबल न्यू हिम वेल एंड डिड नॉट माइंड इन द लीस्ट व्हेन ही इज शफल्ड इनटू द स्टेबल विद हिज मिस्टर मिस्ट्रेस. वो जब वो उन्हें ध्यान से देखता रहता था कि जब उसकी जो मिस्ट्रेस थी मतलब जो लेडी थी जिसने उसे पाला था, वो उन सभी को क्या करती थी? इधर से उधर ले जाती थी. इसे वो बहुत ध्यान से देखा करता था, लेकिन उसे कभी भी इस बात का बुरा नहीं लगता था कि उसकी जो लेडी मिस्ट्रेस थी वो उसे इधर उधर घुमाने नहीं ले जाती है. एंड द चिल्ड्रन यूज टू राइड ऑन हिज बैक एंड हैड मोर देन वंस बीन फाउंड asleep in his kennel between his two paws. कई बार, it means many times, the children were found slept in the kennel of the bear. कई बार ऐसा हो चुका था कि children जो थे वो उसके back पर मतलब उसकी पीठ पर खेलते रहते थे, और खेलते खेलते कई बार वो उसके kennel में पहुंच जाते थे, और कई बार उसी के यहाँ सोए हुए मिलते थे. इस बात से लोग बहुत डरते भी थे. And the three dogs, वहाँ पर तीन dogs भी थे. They loved to play all sorts of games with him, pull his ears and his stump of a tail. मतलब वो लोग क्या करते थे? वो लोग भी भालू के साथ खेलते रहते थे. And tease him in every way. It means they also teased the bear. You can see in the picture also that how they would tease him. You can see the dogs. Okay. Now, who will read? Rituraj, read please.
Main read hai.
Rituraj, are you there? Kindly read.
He had never teased me. He ate the same food as the dog and often out of the head for potato carrots. He has a fast appetite, and his friend, the cook, thought to it that he got his beer as soon as he
had a bit of mice.
And food is what they like best. The hush, he used to say, cook with me, so I had a rotten apple, a salt, and a salt. We had been sometimes an station to climb the trees and help himself to a handful of them. Scared to plunge his nose in there, but tried here with an apple and used find out that he can easily reach any school bus at that time. Now we have learned that it is against the law, but it is all right, wires, for animals that were on the ground. There had also been some difficulties about the behavior. He had punished for this by being put on the field for shooting. With a pleat nose, he had never done it.
Okay, stop. Stop, Ritu. Stop, Ritu Raj. So, now, he teased him every day, but he did not mind it in the least. It means when the dogs teased him, but he didn't mind, he was not bothered about it. He had never tasted meat. It means he never have had the meat and he ate the same food as the dogs. It means the food of the dogs and the bear was same, like bread, porridge, potato, cabbage and turnip. It means the same vegetarian food was eaten by the bear. And he had a fine appetite. Appetite means hunger. And his friend, the cook, saw it to that he got his fill. It means the cook was having the responsibility that the bear is full or not. His stomach is full or not. So the bears are vegetarians if they have a chance and fruit is what they like best. मतलब कि जो bears होते हैं बच्चों vegetarians होते हैं. क्या होते हैं? Vegetarians. लेकिन ऐसा नहीं है, bear non vegetarian भी होता है. अगर उसको अपनी जान बचाने की नौबत आ जाए तो वो किसी को भी खा सकता है. लेकिन generally bear जो होते हैं वो vegetarian होते हैं. ठीक है, एक तरीके से आप कह सकते हो कि वो हर तरीके का भोजन करते हैं जैसे कि आदमी करता है. ठीक है, और उसका कुछ कोई कोई फ्रूट्स तो उसके क्या होते हैं, बहुत ही फेवरेट होते हैं. लेट्स सी. इन द ऑटम ही यूज्ड टू सिट एंड लुक विद विस्टफुल आईज एट द राइपनिंग एप्पल्स इन द ऑर्चर्ड. ऑर्चर्ड में वो राइपनिंग मतलब पके हुए एप्पल्स को देखकर क्या करता था, ललचाता था. एंड हिज यंग डेज मतलब जब वो छोटा था, He had been sometimes unable to resist the temptation to climb the tree and help himself to a handful of them. कई बार जब वो छोटा था तो बचपन में वो पेड़ों पर चढ़कर वो अपने आप को रोक नहीं पाता था एप्पल्स को तोड़ने से, और कई बार तोड़ भी लेता था. Bears look clumsy and slow in their movements. Bears जो होते हैं वो आपको आलसी दिखाई देते हैं अपने movements के according. But they try a bear with an apple tree and you will soon find out that he can easily beat any school boy at the game. मतलब कि ऐसे तो देखने में bear looked very lazy, but at the time when they want to get the fruit from the tree, they will easily climb on the tree and they can beat a small school boy. Yeah, we know that humans are more smart than an animal. But the bear was smarter than a small school boy. And now he had learned that it was against the law. When he was young, he did that practice. But in the later days, he found that it is wrong to climb on the trees. But he kept his small eyes wide open for any apple to fall on the ground. So whenever the apple fell on the ground, he kept that fruit. And there had always been some difficulties about the beehives. Beehives, you know, honey jo hota hai, wo favorite hota hai kiska? Bear ka. To usse beehives khana bhi bahut pasand tha. So he had been punished for this by being put on the chain for 2 days with a bleeding nose and he had never done it again. So उसे क्या किया गया था? उसे punish किया गया था, मारा गया था और उसे 2 दिन तक chain में बंद करके रखा गया. क्यों? क्योंकि उसने 2 times क्या किया था? Beehives को तोड़ कर रख दिया था, मधुमक्खी के छत्तों को तोड़ कर रख दिया था. Otherwise he was never put the chain except for the night And quite rightly so, for a bear like a dog is apt to get somewhat ill-tempered if kept on the chain and no burden. उसे अपनी पूरी लाइफ में दो बार जब उसने बी हाइव तोड़े थे उसे दो बार क्या किया गया था, चेन के अंदर बंद कर दिया था. अदरवाइज उसे जब भी चेन पर बंद किया जाता था तो हमेशा क्या होती थी, रात होती थी. रात में उसे चेन से बांध कर रखा जाता था लेकिन दिन में उसे फ्री रखा जाता था. लेकिन जब उसने ही डिड दैट मिस्टेक टू थ्रो एंड फेल द बी हाइव्स ऑन द ग्राउंड he was punished by the lady mistress to kept him in the chain in the day also. So that's why he did understood that it is wrong to throw the beehives and eat the beehives, and he got easily understood the laws made by the lady mistress. Okay class, so then who will read now? Who will read? Saba Kareem, read beta.
Okay ma'am. He was also put on the scene on Saturday when he spent the afternoon with Horsfire, who lived in a solitary house on the other side of the mountain lake. A good art was to the themselves. It was not supposed to be good for him to wander about the forest with all its temptation. It was better to be on the safe side. He was also a bad sailor and had once taken such a fight at a sudden gust of wind that he had upset the boat, and he and his mistress had to swim to the shore. Now he knew quite well what it meant that his mistress
chain at every Sundays in her absence, and he was also given the temptation. He was also, it means the bear was given the temptation of get an apple after her return. मतलब उसे क्या कहता था, उसे प्रॉमिस किया जाता था कि अगर वो अच्छे से रहेगा, मतलब अगर उसकी एब्सेंस में वो एक अच्छा बच्चा बनकर रहेगा, एक डॉग की तरह, एक गुड डॉग की तरह रहेगा, तो उसे उसके आने के बाद क्या मिलेगा, उसे एक एप्पल मिलेगा और उसके सर पर क्या मिलेगी, उसको थपकियाँ मिलेंगी, टैप ऑन हिज हेड, मतलब उसके सर पर उसे थपकियाँ मिलेंगी, ठीक है। यहाँ तक कि उसके बारे में ये और चीज लिखी हुई है कि ही वॉज ऑल्सो अ बैड सेलर, मतलब कि वो अच्छा नाव अच्छी नहीं चला पाता था। हैड वंस टेकन सच अ फ्राइट एट अ सडन गस्ट ऑफ विंड, एक बार जोरदार झटके की वजह से जो बैर था उसने क्या किया था, मिस्ट्रेस को पानी में डुबा दिया था, और पानी में डुबा देने की वजह से उन दोनों को तैर कर तालाब को पार करना पड़ा था। इसलिए उस दिन के बाद से उसकी मिस्ट्रेस उसे कहीं भी नहीं ले जाती थी। Then, Sabha, now continue. Now nobody is going to speak. Let me read it. One Sunday when the lady had chained him up as usual and was about to halfway through the forest, she suddenly thought she heard the cracking of a tree branch on the winding footpath behind her. She looked back and was horrified to see that the bear coming along full speed. The bears look at as if they move along quite slowly, but they shuffle along much faster than a trotting horse. In a minute he had joined her, panting and sniffing, to take up his usual place dog fashion at her heels. The lady was very angry and she was already late for lunch. There was no time to take him back home. She did not want him to come with her. And besides, it was very naughty of him to have disobeyed her. She told him in her severest voice to go back at once, menacing him with her parasol. So he stopped a moment and looked at her with his cunning eyes, but did not want to go back, and kept on sniffing at her. When the lady saw that he had even lost his new collar, she got still more angry and hit him on the nose with her parasol so hard that it broke in two, and he stopped again, shook his head and opened his big mouth several times as if he wanted to say something. Then he turned round and began to shuffle. Okay, so in this paragraph it came to know that one day she kept, according to her routine, she went to the lady house, it means her sister's house, and when she was going through the forest and she reached the halfway of the forest, she realized that some kind of different voice is coming towards her, and when she looked back she found that there was a bear, it means she found that there was a bear coming and he was not having any collar, so she thought that this bear is of hers and he was coming in the very high speed towards her. And she also find that he was sniffing towards the lady. Sniffing मतलब होता है अपनी फुफकारे मारना, मतलब नाक से वो जोर जोर से हवाएं करता है. ऐसा कब होता है जानते हो? जब जानवर किसी पर गुस्सा होते हैं तो वो स्निफिंग करते हैं. एंड पैंटिंग, वो हाँफ भी रहा था, ठीक है. वो चाहता था कि जो उसकी मिस्ट्रेस है वो उसे साथ में लेकर जाए, लेकिन वो उसे साथ में नहीं ले जाना चाहती थी कि सो दैट ही कुड नॉट क्रिएट एनी प्रॉब्लम इन द मीटिंग ऑफ द लेडी टू हर सिस्टर्स. वो नहीं चाहती थी कि मेरी बहन की मुलाकात में बेयर कोई ऐसी प्रॉब्लम क्रिएट करे. लेकिन जो जो बेयर था वो जाना नहीं चाहता था. और लेडी को इस बात पर बहुत गुस्सा आया कि द बेयर बिकेम वेरी नॉटी, कि वो इतना दुष्ट हो गया है, इतना नॉटी हो गया है कि उसने उसकी बात को क्या कर दिया, अनसुना कर दिया, डिसओबेड, क्या कर दिया, अनसुना कर दिया. एंड शी टोल्ड हिम हर सीवियरेस्ट वॉइस, उसने उसे जोरदार आवाज के साथ, मतलब हड़का कर जोर से एकदम आवाज के साथ उसे घर वापस जाने के लिए बोला. मिनेसिंग हिम हर पैरासोल, और उसने अपने पैरासोल मतलब छोटी सी छतरी से उसे मारने का प्रयास भी करा. शी ही स्टॉप्ड अ मोमेंट, वो एक मिनट के रुका. एंड लुक्ड एट हर विद हिज कनिंग आइज, वो उसको अपनी चतुराई भरी आंखों से देखा. But he did not want to go back. लेकिन वो वापस जाना नहीं चाहता था. And kept sniffing at her. वो उसके ऊपर घूर के लगातार देखा ही जा रहा था, उसके ऊपर फुफकारे मारता ही जा रहा था. And when the lady saw that he had been lost in his new collar, जब उसने देखा कि उसके गर्दन पर जो कॉलर उसने उसे पहना रखा था वो भी गायब हो गया, तो इस बात पे वो और भी गुस्सा हो गई. एंड उसने उसकी नाक पर जोर से पैरासोल से हिट करा. एंड सो हार्ड दैट इट ब्रोक इन टू टू, उसका जो पैरासोल था वही दो टुकड़ों में टूट गया. ही स्टॉप्ड अगेन, वो फिर रुक गया. एंड शूक हिज हेड, अपना सर हिलाया. एंड ओपन हिज बिग माउथ, अपने बड़े से मुंह को खोला कई बार. एंड इफ ही वॉन्टेड टू से समथिंग, जैसे कि वो उससे कुछ कहना चाहता हो. देन ही टर्न्ड अराउंड, फिर वो भी पीछे मुड़ा. एंड बिगन टू शफल, और उसने वापस चलना चालू कर दिया. Back the way he had come stopping now and then to look at the lady till at last she lost sight of him. वो तब तक वेट करती रही जब तक कि भालू वहाँ से वापस चला नहीं गया. Then the lady came home in the evening. The bear was sitting in his usual place outside his kennel looking very sorry for himself. The lady was still very angry. She went up to him and began to scold him most severely and said he would have to be chained for 2 more days. The old cook who loved the bear as if he had been for her son rushed out from the kitchen very angry. उसके बाद जब मिस्ट्रेस घर वापस लौटी और उसने बैर को कैनल के अंदर बंधा हुआ देखा, मतलब अंदर उसमें चेन के में बंधा हुआ देखा, तो वो उसे देखकर बहुत गुस्सा हुई. और भालू भी उसे ऐसे देख रहा था जैसे कि उसने बहुत बड़ी गलती कर दी हो, तो वो बिल्कुल डरा हुआ था और बड़ी ही पश्चाताप की नजरों से उसे देख रहा था. जो उसकी कुक थी वो बैर को अपने बेटे की तरह समझती थी, तो जब उसकी मिस्ट्रेस बेयर पे चिल्लाने लगी तो उसकी कुक वापस बाहर आ गई और उसने उसको देखा कि वो लेडी मिस्ट्रेस उस पर चिल्ला रही है. व्हाट आर यू स्कोल्डिंग हिम फॉर मिसेस, मतलब उसने कहा कि आप इसे किस बात के डांट रही हैं. कुक ने पूछा. ही हैज बीन एज गुड एज गोल्ड फॉर द होल डे, ब्लेस हिम, ही हैज बीन सिटिंग हियर क्वाइट एंड still on his haunches as meek as an angel looking the whole time towards the gate for you to come back. uski cook ne bataya ki pure din ye isi tarah candle mein baitha hua tha aur ye to yahan se hila bhi nahi aur pure din ye bilkul sone ki tarah, matlab gold ka matlab ekdam acche bacche ki tarah pura din wo baitha raha aur kya karta raha, देखता रहा किसकी ओर, गेट की ओर देखता रहा कि आप कब वापस आए. सो बाय दिस वे शी केम टू नो दैट द बेयर हूम she met at whom she met at coming whom she met at the jungle he was different bear now she came to know that the bear whom she met at the forest he was a different bear so now she realized the mistake the lady mistress realized the mistake that the bear was not a culprit he was as gentle as he is supposed to be so for today this much only thank you everyone I hope you all have enjoyed this chapter thank you everyone